Hi everyone, I Shankar Shastri from STMCT Dharwad. Hereby I am giving video presentation on installation of Hadoop version 2.7.3 on Ubuntu 16.04 LTS operating system under the guidance of Dr. S.P. Kulkarni, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, STMCT Dharwad. For installation of Hadoop 2.7.3, the prerequisites are the operating system 16.04 LTS and Hadoop version. The downloaded Hadoop 2.7.3 tar.gz file and Java is installed 1.8.0 or any above version. And you must have some basics of Ubuntu operating system and shell commands. I am installing Hadoop 2.7.3 on 16.04 using command prompt. So this is your desktop Ubuntu. You will get a number of shortcut keys. So this is your search computer key, Google Chrome, files, terminal, settings, local disk, etc. So for executing commands we need terminal, so that can be opened by clicking on this icon, or we can also press Ctrl Alt T like this, and you can execute different and number of commands here. Now I am starting Hadoop installation steps one by one. First, when you boot the Ubuntu 16.04, you get a desktop like this and open the terminal, and I am installing single node cluster Hadoop framework through a command prompt, right? So once it opens, you can execute different commands here, and first check whether Java is installed properly or not in your system. So to check the version of Java, you just use the command Java version. It shows the open JDK version 1.8.0.1. So it means that Java is installed properly. Already I am creating one text file that contains all the commands required for Hadoop installation. So after checking the Java version, next I want to create the dedicated Hadoop system user and Hadoop group. A dedicated Hadoop user account for running Hadoop is required. So while that is not required, it is recommended because it helps to separate the Hadoop installation from other software applications and user accounts running on the same machine. So we are creating Hadoop users and group because of the security and backups. So we can create new Hadoop group using the command sudo add group command. So already Hadoop group is existed in the system, no problem. Similarly, you try to add the user, HD user. So the user is also already existed, no problem. And give all the permissions to HD user. Next, you need to configure SSH. So SSH means secure shell. Hadoop requires secure shell to access manage its nodes. That is, so SSH is required to control remote machines plus your local machines if you want to use Hadoop on it. For our single node setup of Hadoop, we therefore need to configure SSH access to localhost for HDFS user, and that can be created using the OpenSSH client and OpenSSH server. So these SSH command for clients and server are executed and created using following command. First, move to the HD user. SU means switch user. HD user. You can install OpenSSH client using sudo apt-get install OpenSSH client. Enter the password for HD user. So successfully created. Similarly, create the OpenSSH server. So that is also successfully created. Next, generate SSH key for the HD user. See, SSH key generation minus T RSA P and no arguments for this. So here it tells that minus T means what type of authentication you are using. So here we are using RSA and you can also use DSA, no problem. So SSH key generation, this command generates, manages and converts authentication keys for SSH. Minus T specifies the type of key to create for RSA or if you want DSA. Minus P request changing the passphrase or passwordless a private key file instead of creating a new private key every time. So after creating successfully key generation, next we need to go with OpenSSH. Next, check all these are created and redirect to the authorized keys files. Okay, successfully redirected. See, these RSA public keys, RSA public keys are redirected to authorized keys files. Next, check whether it is. Okay. So this command, it is used to test SSH setup by connecting to your local machine with the user HD user. So next, we need to disable the IPv6. So because Hadoop 2.0 or any Hadoop portion is communicated only with IPv4, so that's why IPv6 is not at all used. So that's why first disable IPv6. IPv6 can be disabled using by opening the file syscontrol configuration file. Open this file, HD user. So if you are not getting gedit throw, then use nano. And at the end of the file, this syscontrol configuration file, check whether these settings are assigned with 1 or not. See, for disabling IPv6, so all disable IPv6 equal to 1, default disable IPv6 equal to 1, and configuration disable IPv6 equal to 1. It means that already it is disabled in the system itself by default. So save this and check whether the value is 1 or not for this IPv6. The output of this IPv6, if it gives 1, then it means that it is successfully disabled. See, the output of 1. So this, after opening this file using cat, so means it is successfully disabled. Next, we'll start 2.7.3 Hadoop installation. So open another terminal. Ls command. Extract the file. First move it to user local. We are extracting means we are copying the Hadoop 2.7.3 tarball file to the user local. Then cd user local now extract this. After extracting, change the name, rename. Just we are moving Hadoop 2.7.3 to just Hadoop. We are moving or renaming, both are same. Now change ownership of this file. So CHOW, change ownership recursively for HD user and Hadoop group for the directory Hadoop. For this Hadoop directory, give all owner permissions for user and Hadoop group. Now exit from here and in the HD user go to the now open the bash rc file. Sudo gedit home dot bash rc. This is the configuration file. Here all Hadoop related configurations you can check. So gedit is not working. So just use nano command, no problem. So in the dot bash rc file, at the end of the file, set all Hadoop related environmental variables. See, set Hadoop related on export path. So path, copy and here only. So already is copied. just wait a minute. So it is already configured. So control O, enter, control X. So next, so set the environmental variable. So gedit is not working. Just use nano command for opening the file, and in the Hadoop environmental component file, just enter the Java path. So the Java path is, so specify where you have installed the Java. So in my system, Java home user lib JVM, and the Java version is Java 8 OpenJDK EMD64. Control O, save, exit. Next. So set the core site XML. So this is the temporary file you are creating, and the for all the Hadoop related operations and their files are stored here. In this core site XML file, so in the configuration, you just copy paste so these property: Hadoop temporary directory, so temporary directories and local host name, all those values are comes here. Save it, control O, control S, control X. After core site XML, then MapReduce template file. Make it nano. Copy and paste it here, and change the MapReduce. Here also in the configuration, in between configuration tags, you just so mention the job tracker and the local host name. So here the job tracker, MapReduce job tracker, the name value, and its value is localhost 54111. Copy and here paste it. Save it, control O, enter, control X. So after MapReduce site, so go to the HDFS site. So here we are mentioning the, in the HDFS site XML, we are mentioning the replication factor. In this configuration file XML file, just mention so how many times you want to replicate the data, but here I am taking only one, means in the time of Hadoop operation, only one data node and its values are copied. See, the DFS, distributed file system replication value, is 1. You can change it to 2, 3 according to your needs. So control O, enter, control X. After this, so create some temporary directories. In the app file, in the root app, Hadoop temporary files. Similarly, change ownership of that root app Hadoop temp. See, I have created Hadoop temp directory. For this temp directory, I am assigning HT user and Hadoop group, user authenticated user and authenticated group, all the permissions for this file. Similarly, give execute read write permissions for owner group and others. Next, after this, you format the name node. So it started formatting and successfully the operation is over, means data node is formatted successfully. Then go to the user local Hadoop and sbin, and here mention is just check it all the ls files. So it is displaying many demos, and if you want to start the Hadoop 2.7.3, just give start all dot sh. So it is started all the required demos for the 2.7.3 Hadoop version. Starting resource manager, starting node manager, starting name node, data node. Now already it is completed, and now check it through JPS command, which are all the domains are running in the Hadoop. See, JVM is Java Virtual Machine process status. So which processes or demos that are executing the foreground or background that are displayed using JPS command. So for Hadoop, majorly 5 demos are needed. So name node, secondary name node, data node, node manager and resource manager. If JPS command is displaying 5, means Hadoop 2.7.3 successfully installed on your Ubuntu 16.04 system. And you can check the Hadoop version you have installed. That can be checked by Hadoop version. See Hadoop version, so it shows its version 2.7.3. So we can stop Hadoop by executing stop all dot sh. So this completes the video presentation of Hadoop 2.7.3 on Ubuntu 16.04 under the guidance of Dr. S.P. Kulkarni sir, Assistant Professor, Department of CET, Dharwad. Thank you and all.